Hi everyone. This tapping sequence is for those of you just feeling generally stressed, overwhelmed, and maybe it's something that just feels kind of chronic at this point, in the sense that every day it feels like there's too much to do, there's too much happening, there's too much to get done, and you're scrambling trying to figure out, how do I keep up with this? There aren't enough hours in the day to do what I want to do, what I need to do, what I should do. Ah! This tapping sequence will hopefully calm down some of that chaos you're experiencing. Great to do in the moment when you're feeling that general bubbling up of stress and overwhelm, but also, you can also use it when you're feeling more neutral, as if to prime your body to react with a bit more ease and calm if and when things do start to speed up. To start, I want you to gauge on a scale of 1 to 10, how much stress are you currently experiencing about this overwhelm? Generally, just feeling overwhelmed with life, with to-dos, with errands, with getting to work, with finishing work, with cleaning the house, managing your health, managing your family members, taking care of your animals, whatever it is. How stressed on a scale of 1 to 10? When you've got that number, I want you to put one hand on the chest, one hand on the belly, take a deep breath in. Hold at the top. Slow exhale through the nose. And when you're ready, starting with this karate chop point. If this is your first tapping video, there aren't normally cat meows in the background, so that's a new one. But if this is your first tapping video, all you have to do is follow along, repeating after me, either out loud or just in your mind. And the one point that's kind of hard to see is right on the bra line. And if you don't wear bras, you can kind of imagine it's 5 or 6 inches below the armpit. So back at the start, repeating after me. Even though I am incredibly stressed and overwhelmed right now, choosing to move forward gently and peacefully. Even though it feels like life is only getting harder and I'm never getting the break that I need, I'm choosing to be easy on myself as I move through each moment. Even though I'm completely overwhelmed and don't even know where to start on my to-do list, I'm choosing to move forward differently than I have before. And then moving to that first point above the eyebrows, repeating after me. All of this chaos and constant stress, I'm so tired of it. I feel like I really just need a break. But there's always more on my plate than I can handle. From the second I wake up, I'm overwhelmed with how much I have to do. When I go to bed, I'm already thinking about what I have to do tomorrow. And I notice I find myself feeling more serious than I'd like to. I don't like feeling stressed out. I don't like feeling overwhelmed and rushed. And I want you to even notice, without repeating after me, when you really get to a 10 in your stress of overwhelm, basically stress about stress, where do you feel it in your body? Perhaps a tightening in your belly, a tightening in your throat, a full body clench. Where do you feel it? And if you can, in this moment, just giving that part of your body or wherever in your body is tight, full permission to soften. And then under the nose, repeating after me, I'm a human. Life is hard. Life is not easy for anyone. There's always something. And while I can't control what life gives me, I am choosing to change the way I relate to stress. What if my priority is just doing my best? I'm here to do my best. I could rush through my life, getting everything done, stressing myself out, holding my breath, being a miserable person. I could prioritize working really hard at the expense of my health and my relationships. But at the end of my life, I want to know that I did my best. And that starts with offering myself kindness, sweet words, compassion, as if to cheer myself on as I move throughout the day, throughout each task. What's the worst that would happen if I chose to slow down? Instead of rushing out the door, what if I take a deep breath? Remembering my life is now in these moments. The manner in which I do anything turns out to be how I live my life. And I don't want to look back on my life and remember how stressed I was. So I'm choosing to slow down. I'm choosing to make this life more like a game. We all have a lot on our plate. What if I gave myself permission to have a little more fun? If I dropped the seriousness, what would it do for me to have a little bit more fun and silliness in my day? And I've made it this far. What if I don't need to keep the stress and overwhelm moving forward? I could stress myself out and run that errand, or I could enjoy it. I could hold my breath throughout the workday and hate every moment of it. Or I could find something to delight in. This is my life right now. My life is right now. I choose to start with one thing and to actually be in the moment. I choose to start with this very, very moment right here. Because I am allowed to have more fun than I've been letting myself. I want to look back on my life knowing I did my best, and that includes not taking myself too seriously. No one gets out of here alive. And I want to know that I savored the moments of joy. I slowed down to find the beauty. I prioritized seeing and spending time with the people I love. I choose this every peaceful gentle and easy step of the way. One hand on the chest, one hand on the belly. Take a deep breath in and hold at the top. And a slow exhale, and I'm gonna yawn. And just notice, on a scale of 1 to 10, how stressed are you now? If that number dropped even by half a point, well done. And this is just one example of how tapping can be effective. What we're actually doing is sending the signal to the amygdala and the hippocampus mainly to stop sounding the alarms. Yes, we all have stress, but it's mostly in our perception of the stressor that then makes it stressful for the body. So if we can move forward with a sense of empowerment, got this. I've done hard things before. I can do this. One thing at a time. I got this. That's changing everything. It's changing what's happening in the brain, what's happening in the body, and it's changing our experience of this life thing, this short, sweet, beautiful life thing. I'll leave it at that for today. If you have any questions, drop them below. And if you want more of this, I post a new video every week on the Tapping with Tea app. We also do community calls every month. There's a forum to ask questions and make specific video requests if you want something very deliberate to rewire. So I'll leave those links below, and ta-ta for now. Thanks for watching. Get on with it. Gently, peacefully, smoothly, however you choose. Ta-ta.
Learning, got some videos, some slippers.